Joe and Dina, good evening to you. Their spirits are up, but financially, they are just getting hammered. Bloated blue dumpsters are all over the place here in Steger. 1 week almost, as rain just came and came, was too much in too short a period of time. And yes, indeed, they are struggling, homeowners and business owners.
This right here was the artist area where the tattoos would go on. So, I mean, we had chairs and stations and all kinds of electronics and everything else hanging around here, but now it's rubble.
That's David Slover. He owns and operates Hey Ma Tattoo Parlor with his wife. Not so long ago, before the storm, business was good. Now he's just trying to salvage what he can, which is very little, unfortunately. The ink machines made it because they were up high, but a lot of other things did not. So they've been loading up the trucks and piling up garbage at the curb at the building he shares with his neighbor, Rick Costello. His place is Our Shop Automotive. Many of his tools got soaked and about a dozen vehicles are goners. None of this covered by insurance. They would welcome Governor J.B. Pritzker with open, albeit tired, arms if he would just come visit to survey the damage himself. All of this in hopes of authorizing some government financial relief funds.
My house is up the street. It flooded as well. I've been going since, Wednesday night, about 10.
How many dumpsters do you think you've filled, or how much, you know, material have you lost, loaded out?
Truckloads. Me and the guy next door just been hauling truckloads out, throwing it. At first we had dumpsters, now it's just pile it at the curb best we can.
They're exhausted for sure. They are trying to stay strong. Rick thinks he lost about $50,000 when you factor in cars. David, about $5,000. Hundreds of homes had some sort of flooding. There is a village hall meeting tonight. It's not on the agenda officially, but people are expected to show up and voice their frustrations. And we'll be there to cover it for you. Reporting from Steger, Patrick Elwood, WGN News. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you, Patrick. Officers.